watching you run, run from the sidelines. Taking a breath, filling your lungs, keeping you alive. No fear, I'll be your eyes, I'll be your lifeline. And if I can be, I'll be your strength.
Chance to Change is an employability project working with young people 16 to 24 who live in South Lanarkshire and who have been involved in repeated criminal activity. They must have decided that what they want to change their lives for the better and move away from repeat offending. The method that we use for Chance to Change is volunteer mentors. We recruit volunteer mentors from throughout Lanarkshire and Glasgow areas, people who have the willingness to help and assist the young people and who have the talent and job career history that would be useful towards a young person.
Here at Lackall Community Growers, we work with Chance to Change because we want to show people that they can make choices. And they can either make bad choices or good choices, and we believe that by showing them what we do here, that the people can make good choices in their lifestyles and show them that the potential that they have in the future.
My mentee's a young man from the local area. He's had family problems from quite an early age, which manifested in him an alcohol problem from a very early age before leaving secondary school. That's developed further into drugs, which have had a combined effect, which have been quite serious. And it's helping with those areas and trying to get towards thinking about work and getting into, you know, a life for themselves, which has been the goal and objective of the programme.
Here at James Coyle Motor Engineers, over the years we've had a number of young people begin their working life with the help of various government schemes. Currently we have Mark just beginning his second week now through the Roots to Work scheme, and already Mark's beginning to develop some of the basic skills which we hope will make him a valuable member of the staff.
I left school when I was 16 and I went to college for a bit. And then when I left college, I went to training providers and then I'd done a few placements there. And then I ended up here through Chance to Change. I think without Chance to Change that I would still be unemployed looking for work. But because I've had this opportunity, it's made myself motivated and I've got employment.
Before I came to Chance to Change, basically my life was chaotic, you know what I mean? As I say, I was always in the jail, involved in drugs, drinking, everything enough every day, you know what I mean? Yeah, I was constantly getting myself into trouble. I fell out with my family, my mum, and all that, you know what I mean? But if I started a Chance to Change, I started proving to my mum and that, but I have changed, you know what I mean?
We have a wide range of volunteer mentors on our books, which enables us to get the best possible matches for the young people. We have people with occupations from cleaners, kitchen porters, lawyers, drug and alcohol workers, we have homeless unit officers, car mechanics, sales assistants, we have some joiners, we have a plumber, and we have somebody from the Royal Navy.
Yeah, my life's very varied. I came from a single parent family myself with four children, but I started working at a very early age. I've worked in lots of different kind of roles. But I've done well just through hard work, and that's what brought me to Scotland. But I've done everything from deliver pizzas to be a company director.
I've been involved with them since June. I've got technical skills which I can bring to the project, and also I've worked with young people in the past in training.
It was only the programme I started it, I think it must have been about February, March. But I ended up homeless, so I missed, I didn't see them for a few months. Then I go somewhere to stay, and that's when I started getting back in contact with them, and that's when I started seeing them on a regular basis, and just started doing different things, like coming up here.
Throughout the year we'll have a broad spectrum of tasks to do, from the growing season, planting, taking care of the beds, and also construction projects, which will vary. We try to identify the particular skills that we can bring out in individuals and steer them in that area and develop it.
Yeah, well, initially, the initial training I was involved in was really good, really enlightening, and it reinforces your beliefs about what you think you already know about communicating, speaking to people and getting on, so that's really helpful. What I did personally, I speak to, the employability officer and the project coordinator every week, and I just bounce off the ideas and experiences that I've got with them about what's happening with my mentee, and I find that really, really, really helpful because it helps reflect and focus my energies and my focus on what I'm doing in perhaps the right direction each time I do that, and I do it every week.
The young people who come onto our project bring with them a wide range of barriers that are stopping them from moving on with their lives. This can be from alcohol addiction, drug misuse, a raft of criminal offences that are holding them back. It can be a lack of self-esteem, lack of confidence.
Obviously, your first time, you're not going to say much in your first time, and in your second time, you can speak a lot more about the stuff that you need to speak about. I had a wee boy at 15, and he got put into foster care, and I started speaking to Winnie, and then everything just changed for there. Everything got better, really. I got everything. She got me into courses. She done everything for me.
So once you've been in the jail, and you're at a certain age, that's you. And that means if there's nothing there for you, but maybe a chance to change. It just shows you there is people out there that are willing to help you to get into employment and things like that, you know what I mean?
My colleague and I are also trained as facilitators for the Pacific Institute's the PX2, which is a goal setting course for 16 to 19 year olds, and Steps to Excellence, which is a course for the 19 to 24 year olds.
Got my confidence up a lot and we learn new skills, loads of communication skills, and about the way you think about things and before you do things and stuff like that.
PX2 just made me look at my life like differently, like my moods and things like that, and it was good, all different moods and how fast your mood can change and things like that.
I used to be quite shy, so the PX2 actually helped me because everybody in chance to change I actually talk to now, whereas before I would be standing in the corner like, who are you?
I didn't like working with new people, and I don't like meeting new people. I'm often nervous that way, and it got my confidence up a lot. And I met loads of people there. It was brilliant.
I didn't complete PX2 myself. The STEPS course was valuable, and the training at the start of the programme before we started meeting with our mentees was very valuable. And it really put into perspective the position that some of the mentees are actually in, that they are vulnerable, the kind of age group difference, and really gave you a way to be able to speak to them and approach them that would give some value to it so it could be built upon and be for their benefit as things developed.
The mentee that I have just now is a young girl who is 18. She has been homeless since the age of 14 due to a family breakdown, and she's lived in different homeless units throughout the city of Glasgow. And during that time, she got involved with the police and the criminal justice system. So she's classed as a young offender.
Chance to Change matched me up with a mentor. Her name's Michelle. She's brilliant. She's been through a lot and she's had a lot of jobs in that, so she's got a lot of experience. It's good to have somebody to talk to, and she does want to know and ask questions. She's brilliant.
We talk about a lot of things. I ask her how she's getting on. She meets a social worker. She meets a careers advisor during the week. She goes to the job centre. So I ask her just general things like how is she keeping, is she keeping up her meetings, how is she feeling about herself, what would she like to do, because my focus is to help her move into employment.
I spoke to my mentors about my home life and problems I was having, and they helped me through it. It gave me a lot of confidence, and if I wasn't on the Chance to Change programme, I would be stuck in the homeless unit with nothing to do, but it's got me out, got me a job, and now I can get out and about.
She's motivated me so much to get the confidence to go out and do things and meet new people, because that's where I lack the most. I have more structure to my life now than before. It was just all over the place. And I definitely know I need to get up and do things in the morning and not just waste away. The Chance to Change has had me in a few courses. The Prince's Trust was one of them, and that helped my confidence a lot. And then after that, I started looking for more jobs. And then shortly after that, I applied for college again because I felt like I was ready. So they've helped me a lot now. My advice for people who are going to join the Chance to Change programme is to stick in with it and get involved in all the group activities. It's brilliant, the things they do for you. They'll help you out with anything you need, any worries you've got, you just tell them. They've done loads for me, they've sorted out a lot of problems in my life for me. So if you need any help with anything, they're there for you all the time.
I think young people should get involved with Chance to Change. It helps a lot, and you gain employment and you learn new skills.
The best thing about Chance to Change is Ian and Winnie. To be honest, Ian and Winnie are the best thing about Chance to Change, because they always want to help. They're always there if you need them. Doesn't matter whether I've texted Ian before at 4 o'clock in the morning and he gets back to me at 7, 8 o'clock in the morning first thing. So if it wasn't for them, Chance to Change really wouldn't work, because they give their 100% in everything they do.
The workers, I actually think they're amazing, and you'd look at them and you wouldn't think they'd understand you, but they really do. They understand everybody's situations. I think they're great.
Letting them realise that they are important. They're not nobodies, you know, and they do have a future. But the future lies with them. But sometimes they just don't realise it and need some help just to bring it out.
But at the end of the day, it's only you that can change, you know what I mean? People can help you, but you just need to help yourself, you know what I mean? I know.
Watching you run from the sidelines.
So as you have seen, the project is engaging positively with the young people of South Lanarkshire. We are obtaining real fantastic successes. Young people getting full-time employment, not repeating the criminal offences that they've been involved in, and moving forward with their lives, contributing back into the community of South Lanarkshire.
Why are we